Hello students, welcome to this session. In this session I'll be discussing these two topics, which is the structure of Java programming, as well as we'll see one program based on multiple classes in a single program. Okay, coming to the structure of Java program, so in structure of program, Java program will be divided into several stages. In that first stage, that is in the first stage, you're going to have is the documentation section. So first section will be the documentation section. Documentation section, as you know, whenever you want to explain something about that particular program, you want to give some description of that program, we'll be using documentation section. In documentation section, usually we'll be using comments. The comment lines, what you have already discussed in the C programming language, similarly in Java also you're going to have comments. So there are different types of comments, like single line comment, multi-line comment, multi-line comment, as well as you have a Java doc. So these are the different types of comments that we have, that we'll discuss in the next sessions. Now, as you know, first single line is whenever you want a particular line of statements to be made as comment, then we'll be using single line comment. Like for example, I'll be using this backslash for representing a single line comment. If you want to use multi line comment, we'll be using this symbol for multi line comment. And if you want to make Java based documents, then I'll be using this comment lines for creating a documentation. So in documentation section, we are going to have the lines of statements which are not for execution, which is used only for the description of that particular program or any particular statement. If you want to give describe that particular statement, we'll be using comments. There will have those three types: single line, multi line, as well as document. After that, in the next section, package section. So package section is that nothing but where you're going to have package is nothing but some group of files. Okay, these files will be in the form of classes as well as interfaces. Now what is the use of packages? For example, if you consider you have a folder, in that folder say for example I have some set of programs that is related to C, and I have a set of programs that is related to Java. Now, under that we have some programs that is related to part A and part B. Again, in Java, again we have part A, part B. In that section, we are going to have two more folders here, like say part A as well as part B. Again, part A and part B. So that is nothing but, simply to say, package is nothing but it is used for grouping some set of classes and interfaces which are related. Example, you can consider if I'm doing a Java program and I have two sections there, part A and part B. I'll create a folder called as Java and I'll create a folder called as C, where I'll be having this folder contains all the programs that are related to Java lab, and this folder contains all the programs that is related to C program. Under that, part A will be separate with separate folder, and part B will be in the separate folder. Like this, if you want to group some set of classes in Java, we'll be having package. Okay, so you can create, or you can create packages in the Java program by using the keyword called as package. So that we'll see while doing the programming. Okay, now coming back to the next section, the next section will have import section. So import section is, it is just like how you use to include. Say for example, whenever you want to include some files into C program, we'll write something like hash include stdio.h. So that is nothing but stdio.h is a library file. That library file we are including into our program by using this statement, which is hash include. Similarly, In Java, if you want to include any predefined files, we'll be using a keyword called as import. So simply to say, import is nothing but a keyword that is used to include the library files or predefined files into our program. We'll be using import. Example, say we'll have simply if I write something like import Java dot, say I have created two folders previously, that is Java and C. Under Java we had part A, again part B. Similarly, so first Java is a folder, under that folder I'll have a file package called as A. Under that file, if I have 10 programs, I want to access all those 10 programs, I'll be representing *. If I want to access only one particular program, that is program 1, then I'll be writing program 1. That's all. Say I am importing a Java package. Under that package I have A, that is a sub package. Under that package I'll have a program called as program 1 that I need to include into my program. So I'll be using import dot java dot a dot prg 1, right? So that is import section. After that import section, next you'll have class as well as interface. In this section we are going to define classes as well as interfaces. After classes and interfaces, we'll be having say subclasses as well as sub interfaces. Okay, now let us say you can write one more class here and interface. Subclasses you can define, under that subclasses you can write the functions, main method or variables, whatever you have, that you can define. So while coming for class and interfaces, classes is nothing but whenever you want to define any method or any local variables, those things will be defined in classes. So class contains, what are the things that will be present in the class? Class will contain methods or method definition and also variables. So these things will be present in a class. If I say interface, what is interface? Interface is nothing but it will contain only method declaration, not the definition. There are two different things, declaration and as well as definition. When I say declaration, declaration does not contain body of the function. Say for example, if I write something like void add, and if I write something like this, this is nothing but method definition, because I have a method called as add. In this method I have a body of that method. Say for example, I'll write c equal to a plus b and I'll print the value of c. Okay, that is nothing but for this method we are including the statements with it, that is body of that particular method. This is called as method definition, that is present in class. But method definition is not written in interface. Method declaration is present in interface. So interface is collection of methods which is having only its declaration but not definition. We are going to study in detail about that particular topic in the coming chapters, right? Again, in class we can define variables without any like say for example, variables that you can alter. For example, the same thing if you want to do in interface, it is not possible. In interface, if you want to define any variable, that variable should be static as well as it should be final, or in simple words, it should be a constant. Okay, so interface, whatever variables you are going to define, that variables will be constant variables whose values cannot be changed. So this is about your about the structure of Java program. So in the structure of Java program, we'll have documentation section where you're going to represent the comments, and package section where you're going to group the files and classes, class and interfaces together by giving the package name, which is package. And again, third section will be import section. Import section where we'll be including some predefined library files or already existing classes into your program with the help of import keyword that we are going to do in import section. So then we are going to define the classes as well as interfaces. Under that classes you can define the subclasses, or you can have method definition as well as variables in classes. Whereas in this one interfaces, we'll be having only method declaration as well as static variables. So that is about the structure of Java program. Now we'll see a simple program with multiple classes. Okay. Now, first, I'll just give you one example that we have seen in the previous session. That is, previous session we have written a program to print some value. Let us say hello or something like that. So whenever you want to start any Java program, first we can give the documentation section just like something like this: multiple class. So this is a documentation section. So that is nothing but it is optional. We will be writing a single line command. I will be representing a program name called as multiple class. Okay. Next, if you want to include any program, any files, I can write say import java dot some file, whatever I want, I can include that. If it is not required, I can skip that. And if you want to create a package, you can create a package by using the keyword called as package. I don't want to do that. I'll just start with the class. So I'll write something like class demo. So this is the class name. Under that class, I need to define one function. So I'll make that function as static. Okay, so static function one. This will be the first function, that is function one. And this function I will be writing system dot out dot print ln. So I'll be writing demo a. Okay, this is one class. Again, similarly, I'll be writing one more class. Say one more class called as class demo b. Okay, under this class I'll write the main function like static public static void main. So I'll be writing public static void main. Under this we'll write string arguments. That will be the parameters for the void function. Then here, now, so we have defined this static function here. This function I need to access in this class. So by default it will be private. So if I want to access there, say I'll make it as public. So then I'll write, what is the class name? Demo a. So as we discussed in the previous just now, I told you something like, if you have a folder called as Java, under that folder I'll have a folder called as a. So then I'll be accessing java dot a. Similarly, whenever you want to access any method that is present in a class, we'll be using dot operator. Okay, so that is similar to that how you used to use in structures of C programming. Okay, now I have C, I have a class called as demo a. Under this class I have a method called as function one. Now I want to execute this method. In that case, I'll be just writing first that particular class name, that is demo a dot. What is the method I want to access? I want to access the method or execute the method called as function one. And then I'll just close this method as well as I'll close this class. So once this program is compiled, so we have two steps to compile. First, whenever you want to compile the program, I'll be writing something like java c space. Java c is nothing but java compiler. Now I want to compile the program. Now before compiling the program, I need to save this program. Whenever I want to save this program, see, you have two classes here. One class is called as demo a, other class is demo b. Okay, now if I want to save this program, I need to save, I can save this program with any name, okay. So, but already you know that program will always start execution with which program, which function, it will always start with main function. So, whichever class contains main function, it is better or it is a good habit to save that program with that particular class name. Say for example, I have two classes here, demo A and demo B. In class A, I don't have main function, but in class B, I have a function called as main. So, I'll be saving this program as demo B dot Java. I'll save this program as demo B dot Java. Now, I want to compile this program. Since I want to compile this program, I'll be using Java C space. What is the program name we have given? It is demo B dot Java. Now, once I do this, the compiler will check for the errors in this program. So, both this class 1 and class demo class A as well as demo B, both the class will be in a single file and that will be saved as demo.java. Now, once I compile this, if you have any errors, it is going to list the errors. If you don't have any errors, it will not show you any errors in the list. After that, now once that is done, so we have discussed the concept called as bytecode. And I told you bytecode is nothing but what? Dot class file. So this we have discussed in the previous sessions, right? Now once the program is compiled, in the folder you will be seeing, first when you save the program, you will be seeing you can see this file called as demo b.java. This file will be generated once you have saved the program. After saving the program, once you compile the program, you can see two more files. Like one file will be demo a dot class and one more file will be demo b dot class. So in my program, I have two class files. One is demo A and one is demo B. For these two separate classes, you will be having two separate files called as demo A dot class as well as demo B dot class. The source code is present in demo B dot Java, the actual program. But once it is compiled, it is going to generate the bytecode. Bytecode will be generated separately for each and every classes. So since I have two different classes, two files will be generated, which is the bytecode, that is the demo a dot class as well as demo b dot class. So once that is generated, now I want to execute the program. To execute the program, we'll be writing Java space. What is the class name which contains main function? Main function is present in a class called as demo b. So I'll be writing something that is demo b. Now, no need to mention dot Java because the execution will be done with the help of class file that we have discussed, like JVM. We'll have JDK. So, if you consider, you have JDK. JDK is nothing but Java Development Kit. Under that kit, you'll have JRE. So, under JRE, you're going to have JVM. So, by using JDK, you can write the program and you can compile the program. So, JRE will also have the files that is required for compiling the program. JVM is nothing but what? It is nothing but interpreter, which is used for executing the program. So, once the program is compiled, you are going to get the class file. So, JVM is going to take which file? It is going to take the bytecode file for execution of the program. So, we are not using this source file, that is demo b.java. Instead of that, we'll be calling demo b, only demo b, which will represent the bytecode. So once the execution starts, it will come to the main function. Under main function, we have a method or we have a class name called as demo a. Under that, we have calling a function called as function 1. So once function 1 is executed, it is going to just display demo a. So this is a simple program. How you have in a single program, you can have multiple classes, right? So hope this is clear. In the next session, I'm going to discuss other topics. Thank you.